Hi, welcome to Fusion 360 video tutorial. I want to do the bearing block now in Fusion 360. And always remember, that's just an exercise to show you some needful things. It's not the best way to do this. It's just an exercise. So let's have fun with Fusion 360. Okay, let's start with a sketch as usual. So go to this one, make it visible, and I want to have a sketch on the X set plane in this case, and that should be a rectangle 5x5, so it's a square. Stop that sketch and make an extrude with that sketch. Make it 5. Now there is no possibility to insert another user coordinate system, and there is no possibility to do 3D sketches. So I will try and use construction elements to get my axis and my planes. So first I need a plane with an offset from the set plane, and this should be 1 millimeter. Okay, now I could do another one with 5 millimeter offset from this one, because I don't want to use the faces of the solid, and another one which is at a distance from this one, again 5 millimeter. Okay, now let's do some axes. First axis through two planes, this plane and that plane. Okay, and this plane and that plane. Okay, maybe hide those planes. Okay, then I need another plane with an offset to the bottom one, yeah, which should be this one, 5 millimeter, and two more, one with an offset from this one, which should be 2.04, and another one from that one, again 2.04. Now let's go for axis, two planes, this plane and that plane. Okay, repeat that one, this plane and that plane, and okay, hide those planes. Now with those two axes I can go for two more planes, so that would be one through two edges, 1, 2, and okay. I could hide those two axes, and I need another plane. Well, that's the wrong one. Okay, and another plane through those two. Okay, don't get irritated, that plane is of course cutting through that solid. Hide axis. Now I want to split the faces and then replace face. So let's start with modify split face, and I want to split this face, this face, and of course that one with this tool, and okay. hide that one. Okay, this looks good. Show it again. And now I want to replace face. So go to replace face. And I want to replace what? This one, that one, this one, and of course that one with this one. Confirm. Hide that plane. Very nice. Now another split. Now I want to split, let's take a look. This face, that face, and this face, and of course that one at the back. Yeah. Splitting tool is of course that one. Confirm. And now replace face. Go for replace face, and I want to replace this one, that one, this one, and of course that one. With what? With that plane. And okay. Hide that plane as well. So I got my basic shape. Now I need to do two sketches. First sketch would be on not this one. I suppose, yeah, plane 7, that's the one. Go for a sketch on that plane, and I need a point somewhere over here. Give it two dimensions. So from this plane, if it's from that point to this one, it's 1.8, and from the top plane, was this one, yes. From that plane to that point, I can't constrain, so I would have to project this into my sketch plane. So that would be this one. Project that plane. Because it's hard to see, maybe hide it. Let's try to dimension this one. Yeah. 2.55. Now I could stop the sketch and make a hole. So go for a hole. Okay. That's a counterboard one, and the point is this one. Depth would be 0.75, diameter is 2.5. Tip angle is 180 degrees, counterboard depth is 0.25, and the counterboard diameter is 2.62. Let's take a look if it's in the correct direction. Yes, and confirm. Next, another sketch on a plane. Let's take a look. I think it was this one. Yeah, on that plane, that's plane 3. So go for a sketch on plane 3. Another point. Somewhere over here. Give it dimensions. From this one to that one, it's 2.7. And in that direction, it's 1.8. Stop the sketch. And despite the point being not in contact with my solid, I can make a hole. So go for hole, select the point, okay. It's a counterboard one, yes, the depth is 4, the diameter is 1.01, the tip angle 180 degrees, yes, the counterboard depth is 3.2, and the counterboard diameter is 1.45. And I got a nice hole. I need another sketch, and this time on that plane, plane 2. Sketch on plane 2. 2 points, so go for point, dimension. This distance should be 0.3, that distance should be 0.5, and that distance should be 4.4, and those 2 points should be aligned horizontal. Stop that sketch. Now let's make a hole or 2 holes. Select from sketch, 1, 2, it's a simple one, depth is 2 millimeters, diameter is 0.25, and I'm done. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my Facebook cat fan page, and please like it, would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching, see you to the next one, bye bye.